Hi friends, today we're doing Unit 3, Lesson 2, the Skeletal System, Axial Bones. Before we start reading, we're going to go over the key vocabulary for today. Our first term is axial bones, the bones that are located down the center or axis of a vertebrae's body. Our second word is cartilage, strong elastic tissue that can be found in places like the tip of the nose and the top of the ear. Our next word is cranium, which is the skull, the hard bones that protect the brain and give the head its shape. Our next word is spinal column, the backbone, the series of vertebrae that extend from the neck to the tailbone. And our last word is structure, a form or shape, something that is made up of a number of parts arranged together. We are now going to start our reading. Hi everybody, Ricardo here. I've got a new riddle for you. We are a column of bones stacked on top of one another. Collectively, we make up our backbone. We begin with the letter V. What are we? Today, we're going to talk about the system that gives your body its structure, allowing it to stand on its own. If you've ever seen a building being built, you know that it has a framework that gives the building its shape and keeps it from toppling over. Your body has a similar structure. Who knows what keeps your body from collapsing? That's right, your skeleton. Your skeleton is made of bones. Bones can support a lot of weight. But they did not start out that way. Before you were born, your skeleton began as cartilage, a firm, rubbery tissue like the tough gristle on a piece of meat. Touch the top of your ear. What you feel is cartilage. The top of your ear will always be cartilage, but much of the cartilage in your original skeleton hardened and turned to bone. By the time you were born, you had about 300 bones in your body. An adult has about 206 bones. So where did all the extra bones go? Do bones just disappear? No, they grow and change over time. Many of them join together, like those at the end of your spine called the tailbone and the bones in your skull. Have you ever heard the saying, hard as a rock? Rocks are hard due to the minerals stored inside them. The outside part of your bones becomes hard by storing minerals too. Minerals enter your body in the food you eat and the vitamins you may take. Calcium contained in dark leafy greens, broccoli, and dairy products, such as milk, is one of the important minerals that makes your bones as hard and strong as rock on the outside. Calcium is also needed to help blood clot or thicken when you accidentally cut yourself. Without it, your blood would be too thin for you to maintain good health. At least until you reach your full height, your bones will continue to grow with you. It's hard to imagine rock-hard bones growing, isn't it? They cannot stretch or bend. So how do bones grow? Well, bones are made up of living tissue. New bone tissue is being made all the time, working to replace worn-out cells and making it possible to heal broken bones. Before you were born, your bones were solid, but many of them have become hollow over time, making them very light, yet still very strong. This is how bones differ from rocks. Rocks are solid all the way through. But bones are porous, meaning they have many tiny holes through which liquids pass. Marrow, a jelly-like tissue, fills the cavities of your porous bones. Bone marrow is your body's blood cell factory. It produces blood cells to fight infection and carry oxygen throughout your body. Bones come in many shapes and sizes. Some are long and rod-like with knobby ends. Some are short and look like cubes, whereas others are flat. And some have their own unique shapes. Even though there are many different kinds and sizes of bones, all human skeletons look pretty much the same. Your skeletal bones are designed in specific ways to support and protect every part of your body. There are three groups of bones that form your axial skeleton: the spine, skull, and ribs. The bones that support the center of your body are called axial bones. It is also the job of the axial bones to protect the most important organs in your body. You've already learned that taxonomists classify animals in two groups, vertebrates and invertebrates. Who remembers the group in which humans are classified? Right, we're vertebrates. Vertebrates are animals with a backbone. Your backbone or spine is actually more than one bone. It is a column of many bones stacked on top of one another. Bend forward and feel along the middle of your back. Do you remember those little bumps running down your back? As you may have learned in an earlier domain, these are your vertebrae, a series of bones fitted one on top of another to form the spinal column or backbone. Cartilage separates each vertebrae, filling in the spaces and cushioning them from one another. Each vertebrae has a hole in it, allowing the spinal cord, an important pathway for nerves, to pass through it. Your spinal column protects your spinal cord, in addition to providing the main support for your skeleton. Your spine is only one part of your axial system. Sit straight up and as tall as you can. Now look at your neighbor. Does the side profile of your neighbor's spine look straight? Probably not. Your spine is curved, looking more like the letter S than the letter I. Can you think of any reasons why it might be better to have a slight curve in your back rather than a completely straight back? If your back were as straight as a board, you wouldn't be able to bend. The shape of your spine allows you much greater flexibility. You've already heard about the fabulous tailbone at the lower end of your spine. So what's at the other end? Use your hand to follow your vertebrae up your back and along your neck to your head. Feel how hard your head is? Who knows the name for the protective group of bones inside your head? Right, your skull. Skull bones sit on top of your backbone, becoming the second part of your axial skeleton, that group of bones that support the center of your body. Your skull comprises a group of bones, 29 in all. Locked together, they protect your brain and some of your body's sensory organs. The top part of your skull, shaped like a bowl and surrounding the brain, is called the cranium. Eight thin, curved bones are tightly interlocked to form this smooth cranial helmet beneath your forehead and scalp. When you were born, these eight bones still had gaps between them, allowing your brain to grow. Because these gaps don't close completely for about 2 years, babies have a soft spot on their heads and they need very careful handling. The rest of your skull bones are facial bones or bones in your face. Put your hands over your eyes and touch your closed lids very gently, pushing up slightly towards your eyebrows. The round openings in your skull are called eye sockets. These sockets are deep enough to protect your delicate eyes. Another hole in your skull is just the right size for your nose, though it is sometimes closed or covered up with teeth. What is the biggest opening in your face? Right, your mouth. Cover your face with your hands and open your mouth wide. Which bone moved? Your jawbone. Your upper jaw is attached to the rest of your skull, but your lower jaw is hinged so that it can move up and down and side to side. Pretty amazing, isn't it? Does anyone remember the three groups of bones that form the axial skeleton down the center of your body? The spine is one. The skull is another. The third group of axial bones is also connected to your spine. Reach behind you again and feel the bones that stretch across your back, wrapping around to the front of your body. What are these bones called? Right again, your ribs. Ribs are curved bones that form a protective cage called the rib cage around your heart and lungs. Ribs come in pairs. Each rib is attached to a vertebra in the middle of your back and the sternum or breastbone in the middle of your chest. Feel your chest. Can you count the number of ribs in your rib cage? How many did you count? You have 24 ribs or 12 pairs in all. I just can't resist sharing a joke with you right now because it fits in so well with what you're learning. What did the rib cage say to the heart? Give up, got you covered. Your skull and ribs both protect vital organs. Organs that you cannot live without. However, your ribs are designed very differently from your skull. Whereas your skull is made of solid interconnected bones without spaces between, there are spaces between each one of your ribs. Can anyone guess why it wouldn't work for the rib cage to be one big solid bone? Take a deep breath. As deep as you can. Now let the air out. What happens to your chest? Do it again. And notice how your chest goes in and out with each breath that you take. Solid bone around your chest would prevent the diaphragm and lungs from expanding properly with the air you breathe. The shape of the spine, combined with the spaces in between each pair of ribs, helps the human body structure to be flexible. I'll be back tomorrow to talk more about the skeleton. Today, you learned about axial bones, and tomorrow, you'll hear a term that relates to another part of your skeletal system and to your arms and legs. I'm looking forward to the next time we meet. I'll be sure to have new riddles. You may now move on to Unit 3, Lesson 2, Google Form.